stuff that came out, the charge I'm charged with is no longer, well, they changed it. Since the first step back, they changed the law. So now, today, I have a 51-year sentence, but if the law was applied to me, I would have went home like 15 years ago. The way the law is set up now, it's changed, but it wasn't made retroactive, so I didn't get the benefit of it. So that's kind of like my biggest thing. And the first step that came out, so a lot of lawyers had reached out to me, a guy named John Gleason. And he was trying to help get the benefit of the First Step Act. But I don't know how that's going to work out. But so far with the clemency, it's kind of like, I guess, in a standstill, I guess. I got some followers that still active. I really haven't done anything with it lately. Guess we've been waiting to see what the Biden administration was going to do about it. I mean, the clemency project or whatever. From Gary, Indiana. It's kind of like a crime-ridden area. I don't know if people are familiar with, but the city of Gary, Indiana, it's kind of, right now, it's just a desolate place. It's a lot of broken people with a lot of, coming from broken situations, you know, and it's just a broken mentality, you know what I'm saying? And there's no excuse, you know. I don't feel like it's an excuse for how we perform, and I also feel that, you know, when you're placed in environments that is non-conducive for your growth, you know, a lot of times it's not a coincidence that we don't grow. I got arrested when I was 20.
This call is from a federal prison.
I had a robbery case. I was running away a while back. I kind of did a lot of time in alternative homes and things like that. And I was living with my grandmother for a while. She couldn't really afford to take care of me. And I ended up getting caught up in the system. So I was doing a lot of time in alternative homes and foster care and different things like that. So me and my brother, we was real close. We both was in two different situations because he was a runaway as well. And one day he ended up going to jail, and I kind of lost touch with him. Like the only person who was really my own relative that I was out there real close to. So in the means to try to get him back out of jail, me and a couple guys did a robbery just trying to post the bond to get him out of jail. And we didn't have enough the first time, so we did it again. And then we got the money to get him out of jail. I got him out of jail. That turned into me catching this case. And they offered me a plea for 20 years. And when I decided to go to trial, I ended up getting 51 years based on the stacking, the Title 18 U.S.C. 924C gun stacking law. And the gun stacking law took the one crime, and because of the amount of victims in the crime, it gave me a gun for each person. And I ended up getting 3 sentences for the guns. So I ended up getting 45 years for the guns and another additional 6.5 years for the robbery. I've been placed in an environment that was conducive for my growth in prison. I've accomplished so much. I've been a mentor in the program. I mentor other guys who struggle in institutions with getting along in prison. I've been doing that for over 10 years. I'm a mentor for mental health, guys who struggle with hurting themselves or suffer from borderline personality disorder. I mentor them. I'm a pillar in my Christian community here at Terre Haute FCI. I spent on relief 10,000 hours in apprenticeship programs and just self-help programs. I've been a suicide companion where I've did 24-hour watch on guys trying to commit suicide. I've authored a different book. I've sent articles out. I've held the same job for over 15 years. I've recently connected back with my parents. They're just amazed at how much I've grown since then. We kind of get back on the right track. My daughter, I have a 23-year-old daughter who was born when I came to jail. She's 23 now. I have 2 grandsons now. I just want to spend some time. I want to have an opportunity to be a father to her, or at least a father to my grandson. I've found the value of life in a place like this. You know, it's sad, but I had to come to jail to find out what freedom really was. And now I'm free. I'm in prison, but I'm nobody's prisoner. I authored on articles. I wrote different articles.
This call is from a federal prison.
For the author, who's a writer for the Daily Beast, Vice magazine. This acts input on different stories, short stories and stuff like that. Do with Miss Amy. Amy Povar kind of helped me connect with a couple guys on writing stuff like that. I'm a motivational speaker here in the institution. I'm always called up on different, any transition ceremony or graduation. They call me in to speak at it. I got a lot of stuff I can really see. I got like letters from the doctors, letters from different staff members here write on my behalf and different things like that. things I write a lot. There are a lot of times I'm petitioning to somebody or things for support or just write things because it's just certain things I feel like. What is real freedom? I write stuff about that. What is remorse? You know, because I feel like a lot of times we ask that a person be rehabilitated. You know what I'm saying? And I've learned that rehabilitation is one thing. It's like bringing something back to its former state. But I feel like being remorseful is deeper than just rehabilitation. You know what I'm saying? It's a deeper commitment than just rehabilitation. I write a lot, and that was like some of the stuff I'll be writing. I'll be willing to share it, you know what I'm saying? It's just, I write different. Yeah, I write a lot of different things, basically about my freedom a lot of times. You know, certain situations I grew up in, how I look at my, I feel like...
This call is from a federal prison.
I went through a darkness at a time. I felt like being incarcerated bring about a darkness in my life, you know what I'm saying? And I looked at it from two different ways. As time went on, I started realizing, is it, you know, it could be darkness from a womb or darkness from a tomb, depending on how you look at it. You know, you could be birthing something new through this darkness or dying in it, you know what I'm saying? So I said, what could be birthed out of this? Create something new out of it. And that's kind of how I geared my whole life. You know, in the past, that's how I came to grips with, you know, this ain't the end. This could be something big if I allow myself to take it for what it is and use it for that. So that's kind of how I've been performing in life, you know. And a lot of times, you know, I tell my story, and I use my story as a method that, you know, even though I'm in prison, I don't have to be a prisoner, you know, basically. You know, and that's kind of how I've been driving ever since. I really want to see a lot of the certificates, the different stuff I completed, right? And what I want them to see is that everybody here don't necessarily deserve to continue to be here. I feel like, you know, housing me in prison serves no more of a purpose. I just believe that. I feel like, and I'm not saying it just to say it, I'm showing it through my actions. I'm showing it through my work. I'm being a change in the different environments I go to. I'm just not saying that. I'm being a change, you know. I didn't come to jail and just stay out of trouble. That's easy. That was easy, come to jail and not get in trouble. But I teach people how not to get in trouble. I'm not just a person who keep myself out of trouble. I keep others out of trouble. I teach other people how to stay out of trouble, you know, and I think that's what society needs. It don't need people to just come out there and get out the way because we have a dying society that's going on out there. We got a lot of youth that's destructive and destroying things, and I feel like I can be part of the solution, you know what I'm saying? I was part of the problems. You know, I feel like I want to go back and help rebuild some of the stuff that I helped destroy, you know? I feel like certain communities was in bad situations because I played a part in that. And I want to be part of the solution. I want to be part of the person that go out there and help build them back up because I was part of the person that helped tear them down. And I don't want them to just look at me saying this, but look at my work. You know, because I know when you come to jail, it's a thing in court they call the 3553A factor. And what that is that's something that they use to determine what your sentence should be. And a lot of times, what we do in a 24-hour period is what we get sentenced by. What I did on such and such day got the judge to give me a 51-year sentence because of what I did on one day. In a 24-hour span, I was able to get a 51-year sentence for what I did in a 24-hour span. And you kind of determine the person I was in a 24-hour span as a person that was deserving of a 50-year sentence. So my thing is, if you can determine to give me a 51-year sentence for what I did in a 24-hour span, can't you see, use the same method to determine what I should get for what I did after 20-something years? Because I think that's more of a tell about who I really am. What I do in 20 years is more consistent with who I am versus what I did in a 20. Because you can have a bad day. You know, you and your wife can have an argument. But that don't mean it's not a good marriage. That don't mean 20 years is a bad marriage. We just had a bad day in a 20-year marriage. What we did for the last 20 years is determines what type of couple we are. You know, not what we had, the one bad day we had. And I think that's what we get lost in sometimes when it comes to the system. We throw people away. I mean, they literally threw me away for 50 years about what happened on one day. I just feel like that. And a lot of times when they use the 3553A factors, that's what they use to determine your sentence. How old is he? What is past like? What was his age? What is health like? What is education like? Use those same 3553A factors and determine who I am now. Now, I want society to just look at the system like that. Your gun stacking laws, it's a case called Weldon Angelos. This is a guy I kind of communicate with now, right? Via through other people. His name was Weldon Angelos. He had a 55-year sentence for the same thing I'm in jail for, the gun stacking. And in the case, they show how many people will go home, what kind of cases you can catch and go home before him. And according to the sentencing guideline and what they use to sentences, According to the sentencing guideline, you can detonate a bomb in the plane and go home before me. You can rape this many children and go home before me. You can sell weapons to a terrorist group and go home before me. You can sell secrets of the government to a terrorist group and go home before me. It's just so many things that, you know, and I'm not trying to say I don't deserve a sentence, but look at our justice system. It's just the lopsidedness of it and what we pay attention to versus what we don't. And I know I deserve the punishment. And that's the average sentence for murder in the feds is 20 years. I'm on my 23rd year, and I didn't holler at nobody. I let alone pinch him or punch him or shoot him. I didn't do none of that. But I done did twice. I done got more than what you get for murdering somebody. So my thing right now is we get support for clemency, and we get support writing to the president, or we get support pushing for the bill to get changed. Those are things I'm looking for personally. Support in my clemency petition to the president, and also support on the bill, pushing through the different organizations. I don't really know how I can get outside of just supporting a local congressman or whatever, talking to or petition for a local congressman to get him to help push that bill. That's the only thing I can think about the bill. As far as my clemency, I can petition to my clemency. You know, they can write, petition the president on my behalf on clemency. And I have a page set up with my petition on it.